Mary McLaughlin and his wife Linda. We built our house in 2006. And we never thought anything about this. We put the best everything we could get into it. And basin slabs, a two-story house. All we've done on the floor heating, geothermal heating, so we've done the best everything we could in it. And so this was the last thing we expected ever to happen, you know, so.
Sorry, a few years ago, about 3 years ago, well, before that we noticed, you know, these wee cracks coming, and I could say, Leandro, there's cracks out there in that wall, these are there, the hairline cracks. So then we got our house painted, the outside of it painted, and the painter filled in the cracks. And I said to him, do you think them cracks would be anything to do with that white stuff they're all talking about? Because we didn't really know very much about it. And he says, not yet, or something like that. So after that, then we noticed that it was our front porch first started to get really bad, you know, bigger cracks on it, and our front door was kind of pushed over, but that there was you know, the wind blowing in, like, and we sealed that, and then a large piece fell out of the front porch. And
you could hear it cracking at night.
You know, we could hear these wild cracks when we were in bed. So that really scared us, and it was, like, I thought it was a wee bad looking, because I thought, you know, our house was nice and we'd put everything into it. And, you know, at our age, like, we sold our house, so we had the money for it to build. But, like, at our other house, we had a bathroom and three bedrooms and a sitting room and all. But we didn't have an ensuite and all. So we just thought, like, it'll be something for our family after our day. And that we would be, you know, we'd be comfortable when we do the things and we put on the underfloor heating and, you know, do things like that. And we were shocked when this happened, and I got one of my sons then, I thought it was very bad looking, I couldn't look at it, and he kept saying to me, you know, there's mica in the houses, and don't be fixing that, because, you know, but I got him in with the mixed concrete, and we kind of patched it up, and looked a wee bit better, and we painted over it again. But that's all now, the cracks are starting to open, and now the cracks are starting to appear, like, over the corner of the houses, and on the windows, you know, more recently. Yeah, every time we go out, you kind of see another, you know.
New cracks now, every time you go out around the house, we didn't really see. Yeah. We're sort of in denial, I suppose, for a long time. You don't want to.
No.
I think it's unthinkable to think of tossing our house. You
know, absolutely.
We put so much love. Like, we're pensioners.
We're 15 years working after we built it in 2006 or whatever. So it's a lot of improvement over the years since, you know, bits and pieces. And that's a lot of work to think you would start tossing it.
I can't imagine. I can't imagine our house being tossed and having to build again. Even, you know, I can't get my head around that. We're waiting to be tested now at the minute. So, like, I thought, you know, maybe if it was outside block, we could live in the house and we wouldn't have to move out, because we don't know where we would go. And, you know, but.
But then with the mason slabs, they say that's hardly.
You know, they're telling us it could be dangerous to just go with the outside block.
So everything's sitting on the outside wall, so, you know, we don't know what it's like, and or what it's going to be like in 4 or 5 years.
Must be very stressful for you guys.
It's very stressful. Yeah. And, like, we have, like, a boiler house out the back, and all the equipment that came with the underfloor heating is all in there. Our hot press upstairs is a big tank and all these pipes and things. And we don't know, like, what's going to happen to them? How would, like...
Well, it's a lot of plumbing. A lot of plumbing involved in geothermal heating, you know. So it's a big job to start doing anything.
And we paid a lot of money for a borehole, and we didn't know more about that.
Ah, well, you know, it's all part of the geothermal heating, you know.
Yeah.
We done boreholes at the time, you know, and everything was the best, we thought, you know. So.
Do you feel the 100% will help you really resolve this?
Yeah. Well.
Well, we never. Without that, we wouldn't ever be able to do anything, like.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think money wouldn't compensate you. Do you know what I mean? Like, I just really feel I would feel very stressed about it, to be honest. And like, I even dread getting it tested, because you want to hear and you don't want to hear. But I think for all the hassle that it's going to cause, I think money even wouldn't compensate you.
Couldn't be paid for it, you know. It should be no less than 100% at least, you know what I mean? For sure, because, like, why would it not be? You know, like, we done everything right. We bought the blocks and paid for them, and we bought everything else. And, you know, so there's no, like, there's no reason why it shouldn't be 100%, you know, because, like, that was definitely, you know, somebody else's problem, it wasn't ours, you know. So that's the way it is, we say, you know. So why should we have to build a house twice, you know, or pay anything twice, you know?